So this is a video just bringing it all together from the previous videos and actually running an encounter. So the first thing we need to do is just make sure that we have our characters in the combat tracker. So I've previously made a dwarf fighter and a halfling thief. So we're just going to add those in. Dwarfy's been in. Had one from one of my previous videos. So these guys are just in the combat tracker, ready for anything that's going on. They're traveling around, and at this point they're just crossing a bridge. They're going to be crossing a bridge from the north to the south. I kind of know that, and so I'm just going to put a dwarfy and thiefy walking across this bridge. Now, I've already previously kind of linked an encounter here that there's going to be three goblin warriors, so I know through either story entry, reading the scenario, or designing it, or whatever, that there will be three goblin warriors that are going to be an encounter as these characters walk over the bridge. So, just to add the goblins to the map and to the combat tracker, just add them. At this point, they're not visible to the players, but pretty much the goblins just appear and they're pretty much there. There's no surprise or anything like that. So I'm just going to make the goblins visible to the players. So the goblins have been added with their standard initiative. They've been added with group initiative. This is something you can change. Auto NPC initiative. It can be off, so it doesn't roll when it adds in it up to you to roll them. It can be on. It can be group. So that means all the same creatures have the same initiative. I'm just going to change that to on, and I'm going to re-roll the initiative for all the NPCs. And now we get different initiative rolls for all of those goblin warriors based off the plus one initiative that's actually available there. So I could change that to have been plus five for stealth if I wanted before I rolled that. Or before I added those NPCs actually to the combat tracker. In a later release of the rule set, we're going to have toggles in here to change which initiative value to use, perception initiative or perhaps other skills. But at the moment, it will purely roll off what that is in that initiative. So this combat suddenly happens. The players would roll their initiative. Dwarfy's going to roll perception. Perhaps Fifi was sneaking ahead, so perhaps he might have rolled stealth instead to actually. So those are their rolls, and they're automatically being populated. They both got 13. Being populated in the combat tracker. So we're ready for round one, and we just start the tracking. It comes down. Notice that the goblins' attacks have actually come up. Goblin warrior number two, it highlights him. So he's got a speed of 25, so he could move in and attack Fifi. So that's exactly what he's going to do. I'm just going to track. So he moves up there, 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's his first action. His second action would be to attack with his, well, I'll target first. Just you can control left click to target, and you'll see little arrows will appear. I don't know if you can see that 5-foot arrow. And it will also appear in the combat tracker saying he's targeting Fifi. So he's going to roll his dog sizer, which is a critical hit. And then I just roll the damage for the dog sizer, and it's done 10 points of damage. So immediately we've got 10 damage to Fifi. That's not looking very good. And he's going to have a second attack. At the moment, we haven't actually implemented multi-attacks for NPCs, so I just need to apply a -5 modifier manually for the second attack. And even without that, that would have been a miss against Thiefy. So that's the three actions for Goblin Warrior number two. Goblin Warrior number three, now he doesn't like dwarves, so he's just going to target Dwarfy 25 feet away. He's got a short bow here, and he's going to make an attack with his short bow as his first action. The goblins are doing quite well, aren't they, with their attacks so far. That's a critical hit. So I roll the damage. We don't currently have deadly working for NPCs. We do for PCs, but not for NPCs. So we just remember to add an additional 1d10 damage. We've just got to do that manually at this point in time. So that was 4 damage plus another 4 points. So we just manually apply additional four wounds to Dwarfy there. So that was the first attack. He's going to try a second attack as well. With his short bow. With the minus five and everything else that misses. And he really hates that dwarf, so he's going to make a third attack. At minus 10. With his short bow. And narrowly misses. So that's that over and done with. So now it's Dwarfy. Well, he's just seen his friend's Thiefy getting... getting fairly well actually hit there, so he's going to move first. Actually, he's going to move around here. He's going to target Goblin Warrior number two, and he's going to make his attack action. So his first attack action, just got to check he's got any abilities. It's Giant Bane, which is not against goblins. He could use power attack, but that takes two options. You get an extra weapon damage dice if you hit, but it would take two actions. He really wants to take this guy out. Does he do power attack? Yeah, he'll do power attack. So an extra weapon die damage. So for our second and third action, we swing. That is a hit. So again, sorry, at first point, we haven't got additional kind of automation like that additional damage dice. We can... So what we can do is we can either just roll it separately afterwards, or we can actually start dragging the damage already. Keep it held, so your left button's, and click the right button. And that is actually going to add that extra damage dice, and then we drop it on whoever we're targeting. Or we could just roll it in the... So it's 18 damage to Goblin Warrior 2. Yeah, so he's definitely dead. So I'll just go through that again. You can... start dragging and dropping a attack dice, and you can use the right click to add an additional dice to that. So that's quite handy for things like that. And if you have targeting enabled, you can either drop it in the combat tracker, or if you just want to drop it on your target, it would do the damage to the target that way as well. Targeting is enabled if that little item icon is entered there. So if you drag and drop into the chat window, the targeting is enabled. So quite lucky there. Dwarfy's actually taken out that nasty goblin there. You notice he's classed as dead, so I can just delete that entry from the combat tracker. It removes that tag. So that's three actions for Dwarfy, one to move, two actions for power attack. And now Thiefy gets to move. He's just going to step out as his first. He's going to target one of the... nasty guys down there, and he's going to attack it with his short bow. So he's got attack of plus six for his first attack. Yes, that does hit with a 19. He's only doing 1d6 piercing damage, so his first attack isn't that great. Goblin's still there. There's a second attack for this round. I can add, so sorry, it's a PC, so I don't need to put the minus five. We have the entries here, so I can just roll my second attack. Which still hits. Come on, roll some damage. Six. Yes, that's enough to take out that goblin, and we can remove him from the combat tracker. Potentially, if I was being... and so that's him removed. So now Thiefy ends his turn, and Goblin Warrior 1. So he would probably run away at this stage, so he would just run off, and you could handle that however you wanted to. But that's basically showing you how to do your combat. Just to show you a bit more information again, I'll show it again. He's just going to move up as an action, control left click. He's going to target Dwarfy, or I could have just dragged that the targeting icon onto who I want to attack. His first attack but second action is a miss, and my third action would be a miss as well. And then we'd move on, and it's Dwarfy's attack. He's going to target that creature there. He'll do his power attack again, I think. Seemed to work quite well last time. He does hit. So start dragging, dropping the damage. Right click to add the extra dice. Yeah, easily killed him. So there you go. That's just a quick and simple example of the encounter. How to do targeting, how to do damage and things like that. Like I say, some of the things aren't automated at this point in time to get the, you know, the initial release one of the playtest rule set out. Over time, we'll automate things more, such as the multi-attack penalty for NPCs, the deadly feat for NPCs. There's any of these have deadly. I think the short bow does. As an example, you see we have deadly 1d10, which on a critical hit the weapon adds a weapon dice. We've actually got that integrated for PCs at the moment, so if we were running a critical and we rolled our damage dice for the short bow, it would roll 2d6s plus the deadly dice as well automatically, but we just need to put that in for the NPCs. And then other things as well, you know, like two-handed attacks, we'll add in, and some of the more you know, functionality and things that we get will be added in future releases. But at the moment you've got the base functionality to do targeting, attacking, damage, and things like that to allow you to actually run your combats and get used to the new Pathfinder playtest rules.